I remember growing up around people who loved college basketball, and my elders would always mention the Temple Owls.
One of the premier games of the season coming up in just a few minutes when fifth-ranked North Carolina plays host to top-ranked Temple.
Temple ranked number one under Owls head coach John Chaney.
We are live at the Cameron Indoor Arena in Durham, North Carolina, where the Temple Owls and the Duke Blue Devils are preparing to tip it off.
Against Pepe Sanchez and 15th-ranked Temple.
Temple University men's basketball is one of college basketball's most historic programs. The Owls are currently fifth all-time in wins, only behind Kentucky, Kansas, North Carolina, and Duke, and are the 15th most frequent school to appear in the NCAA tournament with 32 total bids. Despite a national championship in 1938 and a handful of Elite Eights from 1988 to 2001, the Owls have struggled with national relevancy since the days of Naismith Hall of Fame coaches Harry Littwack and John Chaney. Although the program has performed respectably under current head coach Fran Dunphy, the Owls have not had the same powerhouse status attached to their name from the old days. Now, Temple has beaten a top 25 team each year in the past decade, including seven top 10 teams in the past 9 years under Dunphy, but their own consistency in the national polls and during the big dance has been lacking. Though Temple struggled in the second half of their season last year and missed out on the big dance with a 16-16 record, there is reason to believe that next year the Owls will be much better. In fact, a return to the rankings doesn't seem too far-fetched to me when you analyze what Temple has in store in the coming year. Temple's incoming recruiting class for the 2017-2018 season seems to be one of the most motivated, skilled, unified, and highly rated recruiting classes to come to North Broad during the Dunphy era. Guards Nate Pierre-Louis and Devondre Perry and forwards J.P. Mormon and Justin Hamilton provide athleticism and balance to an already athletic upperclassman core. There is something special about this particular group of freshmen that makes them appealing. The four freshmen seem to bond well over social media, even motivating themselves to strive for a Final Four appearance at one point during their Temple tenures, playing for the Cherry and White. It will be interesting to see how each of these freshmen's games translate to a faster, more physical style of basketball, but there's no doubt that they all already have the size, skills, and athleticism to thrive at the college level.
All the freshmen, that's what we all talk about. Like, we look each other in the eyes, like, all the time and just be like, we're going to the tournament this year.
Intercepted by Chuck Brown, who hammers it.
One thing that the Owls struggled with last season was a consistent leader who could guide the team on the court and in huddles. That issue can quickly be solved this season though, with the expected return of redshirt senior Josh Brown.
Brown with 6 seconds. Brown spins at the free throw line. Shot is good! Josh Brown connects. 2 seconds to go. Gibbs from midcourt. It won't go! And Temple steals one on the road!
Brown is the kind of player who can lead a team both vocally and through his play, which would be a valuable benefit for a team that is welcoming in four new players. 2 seasons ago, Brown ranked 8th in the nation in assist-to-turnover ratio, proving how mature of a player he is in terms of taking care of the basketball while also getting his teammates involved. Not only was he one of Temple's most efficient offensive floor leaders, but Brown was also Temple's best perimeter defender prior to suffering an Achilles injury in 2016.
Shift to Temple. Look up.
He's got Jock at the other end. Oh!
Beautiful play by Brown, wasn't it?
The return has been long awaited and has left many Temple fans anxious to get Brown back on the court playing consistent minutes. And with many more offensive weapons surrounding him this year compared to 2015, expect Brown's game to work even more effectively with this season's squad.
In the final seconds, left open on the other end, a big answer by the sophomore Josh Brown. Crawford throws one up, and that's how it ends. Temple in a stunner, knocking off Memphis.
And Netchionia.
Obi and Netchionia started last season scorching hot. For the first 6 games, the junior forward averaged 20.2 points, 9 rebounds, and a 56.3% three-point field goal percentage, highlighted by a 22-point performance in an upset victory over 19th-ranked West Virginia for the preseason NIT championship, which earned him Player of the Week honors by the NCAA.
Obi outside gives a little jab step, hand in his face, and Adrian says, what else can I do? I put my hand in his face, he had to shoot over me, and still it was all net.
Anecioni's ability to stretch the floor offensively with shooting range, paired with his athleticism and size, drew interest from a number of professional scouts and analysts, and although he hit a scoring drought halfway through the season, Anecioni's early season outputs were enough to make an impression on the basketball world, proving that his potential to play at the professional level was, and still is, apparent. After earning a couple of NBA workouts during this past offseason, Anecioni withdrew his name from the NBA draft and decided to return to North Broad for his senior season. Anecioni is probably expected to be the primary scorer this year on a team that is already packed with offensive players, and is even ranked as one of the 50 best college basketball players in the nation for the 2017-18 season by USA Today's The Big Lead. If Anecioni is able to shoot close to 40% from behind the arc again this season, Temple will be one of the toughest teams to keep from scoring. The expectations for Anecioni are high, and there is no doubt that he will be a main concern on scouting reports all season long.
We talked about Anecioni's ability to knock down shots on the wing. When you're pressuring, somebody is left open on the help side. He shouldn't be the guy.
According to ESPN's BPI rankings for the 2017-18 season, Temple currently sits at 41st overall and has an offense that is ranked as the 32nd best in the nation. Temple's offensive firepower at positions 1 through 3 is a big reason for that. The Owls' backcourt depth next season is legit. Along with redshirt senior Josh Brown, junior Obi Anecioni, and freshman Nate Pierre-Louis and Devondre Perry, the Owls will also have reliable guard play from Shiz Alston Jr., Quentin Rose, and Alani Moore. Alston, who is the reigning Big 5 Most Improved Player, is arguably Temple's best one-on-one offensive weapon, with his ability to create space and score or pass off the dribble. He was Temple's leading scorer last year with 13.9 points per game, as well as the Owls' leading assist man, averaging 4.1 assists a contest. Alston also showcased his defensive potential last season as Temple's steals leader, averaging 1.7 steals on the season for the Owls.
Front court, Jordan Price down the lane, stolen by Shiz Alston, leading the break. 3-on-2, over on the right side, Rose's jumper, good! Shiz Alston set it all up with the steal.
Along with Alston in the backcourt will be Quentin Rose, who can also shoot off the dribble, but truly thrives in the open court. Rose is already being talked about as an NBA draft prospect after 1 year with the Owls, and in large part, that is due to Rose's ability to push the pace in transition and finish at the rim.
The way by Rose, he gets it back, drives, lays it up and in! Steal by Dingle, finish by Rose!
As a freshman, Rose averaged 10.1 points per game on a 43.4% field goal percentage. Accompanying Rose and Alston in the backcourt will be Alani Moore II, who despite his 5'10 frame, showed similar leadership qualities to Josh Brown.
Credit Alani Moore with keeping his dribble. Remember I mentioned that? Keep your dribble, create your options instead of picking the ball up.
Moore's knack for commanding his teammates where to go on the floor resembled the way Brown ran the point for Temple in 2015. Moore's feel for the game is truly innate.
Junior in the second half, stolen away by Moore.
Smart play by Moore to back it out.
A three for the lead. Got boom. It!
Just like that.
Moore can not only shoot from the perimeter, but has no problem attacking the rim for a layup or grabbing a rebound even with his smaller stature.
Anecioni rises up. In and out. Oh, what a big rebound.
What a big rebound.
Alani Moore somehow gets the ball back for the Owls. It's kicked out of bounds. And with 30 seconds left, it'll stay Temple basketball.
If you pair that reliable backcourt up with a frontcourt that is mixed with experience and youth from Ernest Flagpie and Damian Moore, plus the aforementioned freshman big men JP Mormon and Justin Hamilton, Temple has the chance to be one of the most balanced teams in the nation next season. And those keeping an eye on the Owls shouldn't forget about this guy. the 2017-18 season, Temple is scheduled to play 10 teams who played in postseason tournaments last year. That is without counting Dayton and Clemson, who the Owls have the chance in playing at the Gildan Charleston Classic, depending on how the bracket pans out. That makes a possibility of 12 postseason teams that Temple will play this coming season. Among the annual Big 5 round robin schedule, which features Villanova, St. Joe's, LaSalle, and Penn, Temple will also play against Wisconsin, Georgia, George Washington, and 2017 Final Four participant South Carolina in the non-conference. The highlight of the schedule, however, will be the two conference games Temple plays against expected top 10 team Wichita State. The Shockers' addition to the American this past offseason was a major conference realignment, and now Temple will get to see how they handle the expected top 10 program each season. The Owls have top 25 talent this year, and a hard schedule to make them prove it, but their success is up to whether this team can find its chemistry early in the season and make necessary adjustments from game to game. It is a tough road ahead for Temple, but if they finish the season with a respectable record that has 22 or more wins for this packed schedule, don't be surprised to see the Owls back in the top 25.